Tucked away behind a row of tall trees, you'll find the Horticultural Gardens and Greenhouse Complex. It's a space shared by students, researchers, and even the public.
It's definitely used by far many more people than you might think.
Built in the early 70s, the greenhouse complex has 8 bays.
One of them is used by grounds maintenance, and the other 7 are used by us. 3 of the bays are used for teaching. So one is dedicated completely to our 1411 class. That is horticulture for non-majors. To have students be able to come into a greenhouse facility and learn how to make cuttings and learn how to plant seeds at the correct depth and all that sort of thing is really critical for them learning what they're supposed to be learning in a horticulture program.
It's more than 13,000 square feet of space, which includes 2 classrooms, an enology lab, and a brand new floral design lab.
A lot of these are houseplants, which like what you'd find at a florist, and of course that's one of the things that we teach about is the different kind of plants that you can buy out in the garden centers.
The other 4 bays are used for research, and greenhouse manager Jennifer Simic says there's a little bit of everything inside, from peanuts to tomatoes, olives to wildflowers, and of course, cotton.
I've had people in here renting controlled environment chambers, small chambers, that where you can grow plants with very specific conditions. I've had people from departments like civil engineering and, you know, curing concrete blocks and that sort of thing, too.
If you step outside those bays,
our annual squares, not everything in here is an annual, but a lot of the stuff is.
You'll find the horticultural gardens.
It's used primarily for teaching and for community education.
The gardens began growing in the 1980s, but are always being updated, like this herb garden.
Built them, painted them, put the landscape fabric down, hauled all the rock in, hauled in all the soil.
Or this vegetable garden.
There's tomatoes and eggplants in that bed.
There's also a rose garden and a new trial section where plants are tested to see whether they'll survive the West Texas weather.
A lot of changes have already been made, and in the future, you should expect to see a lot more changes in the gardens.
Keeping up with the greenhouse and gardens is a lot of work.
The plants need pruning, they need fertilizing.
Simic knows because she oversees all of it with the help of a handful of student workers, volunteers, and temporary employees.
Plants drop leaves even when they're at the height of health, and as many different types of plants as we have in there, it's always a maintenance issue to be going in there and cleaning up after the plants. It's like picking up after toddlers. There's always something trailing along on the ground.
And while she's busy picking up and planting, Simic's work stops here.
The question that I hear a lot is, do I take care of all the plants across campus? And the answer is no. There's a whole division that takes care of that. And there are hundreds of employees or more that take care of all the grounds across campus. But this little corner of campus is ours. And we're out here every day pulling weeds and pruning plants and trying to make it look beautiful.